I was in an office of my friend, who was a software developer. I was captivated, I was captured by the software. When I saw the programming, the developing, this interaction with the machine, I felt, no, this is my job. Really, it was a fascinating, was in, falling in love immediately with the tech field, and this almost is 40 years ago. And then I started to work with some other companies, but then I decided to create my own company to take the risk. I like challenges. I think passion is one of the most important things because technology is a complicated matter. You need to be with a scientific mind, you know, to understand bit and byte, zero, one, percentage, statistics. It's like, but feel your passion, because I think passion is something that can give you a boost, give you a perk in your career. If you want to start a job in the technical field, one of the first things is to really understand if you like this field, because it's a bit logical field, you know, it's working on zero, one, it's mathematic mode. So if you are a people that like mathematics, like logic, like science, this is a perfect fit for you. Like me, I like a lot to discover new things, how they work. I open when I was young with the play with the toys. I open every toys I break because what is inside it? So remember, when you are in the technology, many things are not visible. Many things are not visible. So you must understand that it's not explicit job, like for example, putting or painting a wall where you can see the result. The result is hidden. So I think the first thing is to understand if you are if your attitude is fitting this kind of a job. When I started 40 years ago, learning a new thing was hard. You must buy books. So in my experience, I went to university to understand which kind of books can help me. This is important. But now, after 40 years, everything is changing. Also in learning, you have a search engine. You have a lot of contribution by other people. So I think the most important is to identify your willingness, identify your path, and then try to stay updated also using social media. I know that many people don't think social media can be a knowledge driver, but it is a knowledge driver. So try to focus also on gathering all information using all the channels you have now available that can be search engine, social media, and of course, university. Online learning now is accessible by everyone, so you can graduate staying in another nation, receiving a graduation from another university. But in my experience, everything I felt was inside me, was personal, was motivating. When you go in the tech field, the challenges are every day because, especially now, technology is accelerating very fast. So, one of the challenges I feel is to stay updated with development and also the day after, then we come blockchain. For example, you study blockchain and then next will come the metaverse and then NFT and then the DAO and then the smart contract is something that you. The challenge is to stay updated, not lose the trend. This is very important in the technology field. You must be a lifelong learner. I think if you have no technical background, it's a bit complicated to be a leader in this technical field. You can be passionate about it, and then you can go in deep with the private learning, private study, without any degree, for example. I have the diploma, I have not a PhD, so, but I, in my life, every day of my life, I study every time. So to stay updated, this is very important to follow the change and follow the growing. When I started developing software many years ago. Now I'm no more a developer for 20 years. but I remember, you know, the satisfaction to have a software that works. This is the most important without error. So in the tech field, in the development, you create something, it's creativity. Creativity is something that I like the most because it's something tangible you can see, it's working. You use your mind in a perfect manner. So I think this is the satisfaction every time. Well, in the past, I've used the development software development kit, the SDK, as to develop. But now, as I said, it's 20 years. I do not develop anymore. But I design, I create a project, I create a software on the paper, you know, and then the developers do. The program is the standard program. I can use many other diagram software to create a software like the Microsoft Visio in the past, but now I'm using every software online to create my, to do my job. You need to feel a passion for this job because it's a bit complicated job. But the most is to understand what is binary, what is 0-1, what is the computer, how the computer elaborates, because it's different from humankind. You know, the computer has only 0 and 1, so it must resolve everything with the 0 and 1. So it's a bit complicated. But I think if you like the tech skill, you, for example, can be a network manager, so you can take about networking, connection, etc. It depends on the role you choose. If you are a developer, you need more in-depth knowledge. If you are a software architect, you need to a complete vision about the problem. You need to understand the customer requirements. So it depends on which kind of skill of technical job you are talking. But basically, the skill you need is to have confidence with the technology now, especially now, confidence with digital technologies. Well, as I said before, I was an electrical engineer, not a computer scientist directly, but it helped a lot to me because as electrical engineer, I understand the transistor. I studied the transistor, the gators, how that means, how the computer managed the 0 and 1. So my education prepared me well, but I must I did a great work of study by my personal inspiration and my personal motivation. It is important, as I said before, lifelong learning is very important in this field. Motivation, passion, and focus on what you are doing, it's very important in this field. I think technology categories, we must mention absolutely artificial intelligence, because artificial intelligence is changing the software paradigm. Before, we see software that are deterministic. Okay, the coder, the developer, write one instruction at a time, do this. In case the user press 9, do this. In case the user press 8, perform this step. So, you know, it's deterministic. What artificial intelligence brings the most is the shift from deterministic software, deterministic approach to probabilistic approach. So the probabilistic approach is the most important aspect, I think, in new technology, because every software is affected, is influenced by artificial intelligence. This is great, beautiful. And then the second technology, I think, is the most important, is blockchain, not because cryptocurrency. Cryptocurrency is a phenomenon we must shape also in a regulation framework, but it is disintermediated, so it's a bit complicated. Which blockchain has the enable for new proof of identity, proof of ownership, you know, we are NFT. So I think in the next years, artificial intelligence, because the probabilistic approach to software, the probabilistic shift of software from deterministic to probabilistic, And also, I think blockchain. Blockchain will change everything because we need a system, a technology like blockchain that can assure us integrity, transparency, and stability, immutability. So I think watch closely these two technologies that will be, are not so vertical. They are horizontal technology that can serve many industries and many aspects. For example, IoT, Internet of Things is affected by the infusion of artificial intelligence and blockchain, but also more distributed ledger, like, for example, Tangle. I was not a leader. I was a technical guy. I started at 18 years, so 40 years ago. And I become a leader because I start with my company, because I want to take on the challenge, the risk to create my company. I want to go all in this job. And then I become, let me say, a leader because my team is very motivated, is working well. So it means that the leader is running a company in a good way. But this is inside you. This is inside you because you must never forget to respect the other person. If you have an employee, you have a person in front of you. If you have a customer, you have another person in front of you. So apart from the relationship that link you with these persons, with these people, you must respect the people that is, the person that is in front of you, with the inclusion, take consideration of their needs, and be coherent, be consistent, and everyone follow you every time. Everything in my life, I take this approach. Big things start small. So it is important to start. Everything we do in our life will have a problem. If I want to buy a car, you can find the problem. If you want to change your house, you will find. Don't be afraid to find problems. Problems are a part of our life, and if they are part also on of your working life. If I can depict a bit more about cybersecurity, I want to say that don't approach cybersecurity as a monolithic thing. I want to know more about cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is a paradigm, something that describes security in network architecture or in software or in identification, etc. Try to understand that cybersecurity is a part of the digital life. And the security must be, if you are a software developer, for example, you must adopt best practice for cybersecurity from the beginning, from design of software, not where you deploy the software. Because you can deploy the software, you can assign rights, save space, create a good environment, a secure environment. But if the software is not designed thinking the security from the principle, so we talk it is secure by design. Secure by design, it means you must adopt the best practice for security when you are designing the software. And then don't forget, also staying in the cybersecurity aspect, the paradigm security by default. What is security by default? When you create a new device or a new software that must be installed, you know, everything has configuration, everything has setup. Think to deliver this device or this software with security by default. So set the security before you deploy the software or you deploy the device. When you buy a new smartphone and you open, it is your smartphone. So you have the right to have everything open. Yes, but if you have everything open, you will be hacked after 3 minutes, for example. So many manufacturers include privacy, security, practice from the beginning. So think about it. And also don't forget in cybersecurity that most of the problems in cybersecurity are related to people. So education, culture is very, very important. But overall, in every path you want to do, never, never be, never scared, never be scared, never, don't feel fear, because it's all so based about yourself, the way you can deliver to customers. Mm-hmm.